Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2, where in the last episode we've been finding out that Jacob's father actually didn't die, but was stranded on a planet for 10 years and basically gave in to a not-so-very-adult male power fantasy of being stranded on an island with lots of women and then living there like a king and stuff. So, yeah, that probably shook him up a little, so let's have a talk with him at least. Hello, Jacob.
Thanks for diverting to the Gurren's back, Shepard. I appreciate being able to clean up that mess. Maybe not the best way to learn about the relatives, but I'm glad it's done. What do you need?
Do you want to talk about it?
I'm interested in getting to know you better.
Already? I'm not big on forcing these talks, Shepard. Let's do this later.
Alright.
We'll talk later.
Commander.
Okay, let's check the private terminal then. Hello. An important request from Mr. Gnark Ijal-esk. Dear sir or madam, having consulted with my colleagues at the Citadel, I have the privilege to request for your assistance to transfer a large quantity of Prothean technology uncovered at Isles. Believing this materials to be a hazardous danger, they were locked in quarantine. Even though the test revealed that the fears were groundless, the quarantine remains in effect until one can pay for a permit to request a reclassification from the Cultural Ministry. Knowing of your interest in Prothean technology, I would be happy to deliver most of it into your hands, keeping less than half for myself. As a Batarian, I cannot engage in council official activities, but if you transfer the 20,000 credits required to me, this exchange could be made in your name, enabling us to profit from this happy accident. Please reply urgently with the credit transfer account information. Best regards, Gnark Ijal. Yeah, it's spam mail again, I guess. Right. Kelly?
How may I help
anything
you?
Anything I should know?
Is there anything I should know?
Nothing right now. Anything else, Commander?
No.
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Right, let's check with some people if they have talks. I think Tully and Jacob both waiting for resolving their personal stuff, which we didn't do so far. But Grunt maybe has something new to say. Grunt?
Shepard.
Anything going on?
Just checking in. How are you doing?
I'm branching out. Got a list of enemies now. They all give me joy when I picture cutting them, crushing them. There's this one imprint, a Solarian with a... what are they? The things on his head pulled apart? Bet it caused a generation of revenge. What is that, a few weeks for them?
That's racist.
What did you want?
So you're not even trying to get better?
You know, I kind of thought connecting with your past would bring stability.
See, now we're having fun. Me remembering good deaths, and you with your funny human thing you're doing. My job is to hurt things. Direction, control, that's your job, Battlemaster. You're why I'm a soldier, not dead or crazed like an animal. Thank you, Shepard. You gave me purpose. Now let's find something big to kill.
All right. at least he's trusting us with directing his violence somewhere.
Something
going on here?
Say the Normandy is a she, not a he, right?
Of course. The Normandy's the sweetest girl there is.
And Edie's a she. Tally's definitely a she.
What are you getting at, Kenneth?
I'm just saying I'm feeling a wee bit threatened here. A lot of female energy, and I'm just one man.
You're such a dick.
So, look where your mind went. Got to watch out for myself.
Yeah, Kenneth, you're very much in danger of being surrounded by females at your workplace. Yeah, I guess it's a very terrible thing to happen. Not. So that nobody misunderstands me. In my own job, I'm basically also surrounded by females. Although it's not a basically female profession. I don't want to talk to Samara. She's probably waiting for resolution of her stuff as well. So the only one here who we have resolved the personal stuff with is Miranda, so let's talk with Miranda.
Commander.
Something going on?
Do you have a minute, Miranda?
Of course. I've been meaning to speak with you, in fact.
Okay.
wanted to apologize. I didn't fully believe you'd be up to the task, and it seems I was wrong. Frankly, based on what I've seen, I wish Cerberus had recruited you earlier.
I still don't see this as recruiting. I see this as working together, and I still believe that Cerberus is wrong.
I trust you, but I don't trust Cerberus. Your experiments cross the line.
All the time, yes. But I recall a Spectre who crossed a few lines while hunting down Saren and the Geth. And we'd be lucky to have you. Too many join us out of simple xenophobia. We need more people here for the right reasons.
Yeah, but I saw some of your monsters.
I saw your bases years ago. You were using Rachni, Thorian creepers, even husks to make your own army.
The husks were already dead. The Thorian creatures were mindless, and the Rachni were abandoned once we understood their intelligence. We weren't breeding an army, we were breeding expendable shock troops for high-risk scenarios. How many soldiers died in Saren's attack on Eden Prime? How many would have lived if we'd had just a dozen Rachni soldiers on our side?
What was Cerberus trying to prove by experimenting on children like Jack?
A mistake, no question. Not mine. And one that was corrected once we discovered the extent of the experiments being performed.
You seem to be very defensive of Cerberus, so why is that, actually?
With your intelligence, you could have landed any job you wanted. Why choose this?
Because I still envy the time Morden spent with the Special Tasks Group, working with people as smart as he was. Cerberus never tells me that something is impossible. They give me my resources and say do it. And they've given you even more. A new life, a new ship, the elusive man's personal attention.
And you.
The best thing he did was to put you on my squad.
You'd have done fine without me. I may not have believed it before, but I don't have what you do. That fire that makes someone willing to follow you into hell itself. My father got me the best genes money could buy. Guess it wasn't enough.
Oh, this again. I'm very tempted to say this again, but let's be more polite. I think it's very interesting that she always brings up her genes instead of just saying that she's not good enough.
You always bring up your genetic tailoring. It really bothers you, doesn't it?
This is what I am, Shepard. I can't hide it. The intelligence, the looks, even the biotics. He paid for all of that. Every one of your accomplishments is due to your skill. The only things I can take credit for are my mistakes.
That's not true. You're doing fine. You're just using who you are, so nothing is wrong about that.
You're not coasting on good genes, Miranda. Your ability and your dedication speak for themselves.
Thank you, Commander. I appreciate that. I should get back to work, but thank you for coming by.
Interesting. Maybe there's hope for her yet.
I can't believe the Collectors were once Protheans.
I always pictured Protheans being regal, not giant bugs.
Who knows what the Reapers did to them? Creepy.
Let's check with Dr. Chuck Boss if there's anything going on here. Hello?
Commander, I very much enjoyed sharing that ice brandy with you. But I hope I wasn't too unprofessional. Brandy goes straight to my head.
Oh, I enjoyed it.
It's nice to see you let your hair down.
Guess I hadn't realized how much those feelings needed airing. But I didn't give you much of a chance to vent. So tell me now. What do you think?
Everyone's depending on us. We won't let them down.
They just don't make them like you anymore, Shepard. Well, promise me we'll share a bottle every year. The next one is on me.
All right. So, anybody else we missed? I mean, the rest probably don't have anything new to say, so I guess something going on in my cabin? I don't think so. Right, then let's check out the side mission. Refuel. And then something was going on Joab, so let's check that out.
I have detected an anomaly.
Yeah.
Something.
All right, let's land. From the messages, it sounded a little bit like there was a mercenary gang or something, but basically human opponents are not mechs. So I always want to bring Garrus. It's a little sad, actually. Let's try Samara again, and Garrus. I do like Garrus. I admit it. I'd be the first to admit that I like Garrus in my squad. So come on, this Mr. Bad Guy. I'm sorry. I should really bring some of the other people more often, but I really like having Garrus around. So this gives 5% more health, and this gives 7% more weapon damage. Yeah, no, I take weapon damage. Thanks. I know what I wanted to change. The heavy weapon to the missile launcher. Alright. So there were mercs. I think I'm the only one with an ammo power, so we'll take disruptor ammo, I guess. Alright. No, not that. Game, when will you learn that I don't want to have this fucking SMG in my hand ever? Alright, good. Let's move out. Garrus, take this. Use that cover that you have. We need to stand out and die.
One down.
Not against simple, stupid dullies. Basically. Because that's what they are. They should only be an annoyance. Anything around there? Some element zero again. Yay! And more element zero. Yay! Alright, there's some clips lying around. I'll take them. More clips means more shoots with my sniper rifle, and boy, I like shooting with that big gun. Let's go in. Oh, hi. Oh, not that side. Garrus. Uh, shield regeneration, please. Thank you. Doesn't seem to be anything going on there. There's something in there. Surrounded. It's because there's one idiot there.
One less to kill one.
Fire in the hole!
Good job, Tamara. Commander Santiago, hope you're doing well. Require your services once again in transport of ourselves, our equipment and our recovered artifacts. I've dispatched our representative to meet with you regarding the details of the transaction. Given the sensitive nature of our cargo, we expect discretion in the matter. Dr. Farron, Chief Researcher, Exogeni Special Projects. Dr. Farron, of course you can count on us to offer you escort and transportation. We've sent men and ships your way in good faith. Commander Vito Santiago, Co-Executive Officer, Blue Suns. Yeah. Did I not take that? Take it. Sniper rifle doesn't have full ammunition. I want you to take it, Shepard. What? All right. This one I can take for some reason. Oh well, let's press on. Hello? Hi. We haven't been properly introduced. I'm Shepard. You're dead. Wasn't there someone on the left side? Was. Oh. Hi. Icarus? Shielded hostiles. I've got nothing. Forward. Want to take another one to the head? Alright. Yeah, I can burn. Garrus, where are you, by the way? Get over here.
I'm on it. I'm going in. Light him up.
Now, Garrus, what are you doing there? I didn't tell you to go there, but it's a good idea. I admit. I admit it. Burn, thank you. I think we got them all. We got a commander, we got a lieutenant, I think that should be all of them. Lieutenant Locke, once the artifact is secure and in transit, your orders are to take your man on rendezvous with Captain Voorhees about the MSV Strontium Mu on the Arcan Lacan system in the Omega Nebula. Assist Voorhees with the capture if needed. Commander Santiago. Alright, so we got another mission where we can probably kill more mercenaries. Nice! Nice. Is that Prothean? Apparently the Prothean cipher still works that we got on Therum. Recovered Prothean relic, eliminated Blue Sun's presence at dig site. Right. Did I say right? As I said, you know. Yeah. Alright, but I guess that'll be it for today. Next time we'll head out and do some more quests for our dear comrades in arms. So that'll probably be fun, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.